Tony. You coming to bed?
Not yet.
Honey, I'm sorry.
I know.
Great, you got them at that new nursery on 4th Street.
Oh, no, I sent away for them. I am planning on filling up this entire apartment with flowers so we can convince ourselves that it's springtime.
Well, I thought spring was the time to get outside.
Not this year.
Carly, would you mind picking up a couple of things for me today? Because I don't think actually I'm going to have time.
Oh, I was planning on spending the day here, actually.
You could make a day of it. You could have lunch, go shopping, wander aimlessly.
Can it wait until tomorrow?
Tomorrow it might be snowing. It's gorgeous outside. What did you get out? Come on, please.
Okay. I'll do my best.
Thank you.
What?
Oh, it's not a big deal. It's just, Bobbie always talked about planting bulbs, and you're actually doing it. I'll call you. Bobbie always talked about planting bulbs, and you're actually doing it.
You were Bobby's daughter before you ever walked into General Hospital.
We didn't turn your tricks in no garbage pile.
That's the world Bobby and I came from.
Bobby's daughter. Bobby's tricks. Turn the tricks. Turn the tricks. Turn the tricks. Tricks. Turn the tricks. Turn the tricks.
Have lunch, go shopping, wander aimlessly. You know, selling sex when she was 16 was not something Bobbie did willingly. And neither was getting pregnant by some paying customer. And those people that know or think they know should keep their damn mouth shut.
Yeah, I'd like to order some things to be delivered. Early.
Well, because I wanted to see you. Plus, my last two appointments of the day were canceled. What are you doing here?
Tony, I live here. Unless you're trying to tell me something.
No, I just thought you were going to stay out today, take some time for yourself.
Yeah, well, if I had done that, then I wouldn't be here now with you, would I? Mm-mm.
Ooh, I think I may have lined you up a job.
You're kidding. Doing what?
Physical therapy. Katherine Bell's got to be released from GH, and she wants somebody to work with her at home.
At her home?
Yeah.
When do I start?
Well, she wants to meet you first.
When?
Well, I think I'd go over there right now.
Well, I wouldn't want to disturb her.
You want someone else to get the job?
No. You're right, it's a good opportunity. Will you go with me?
No.
and take a nap.
What, do you have a rough day?
It was a rough night, actually. I spent it worrying about my son living with the man who shot Katherine Bell.
What do you mean? Did Stefan confess?
No. But I think he's going to be found out pretty soon. Anyway, you go to Katherine Bell's. I'll take a nap. When you get back, we'll go out someplace fancy for dinner.
Got it. I love you.
I love you, too. Give anything to get Bobbie back in the brownstone.
Tony.
Hi, you're back.
What is going on?
Just a visit from Uncle Luke.
Filling Luke in on the custody suit and, in my own way, asking him to take it easy on Cassadine until I get my son off the island.
What, is that going to be a problem?
I think Lucas is safe enough for now. It's my sister I'm worried about.
I'm sure.
So, how'd it go with Katherine? Are you going to do physical therapy with her?
You know, I never saw her. I left and I got a splitting headache and I just decided to come home.
You're right.
Yeah, a couple aspirin. I'll be fine.
So, I'll let you know when I'm ready to file. And in the meantime, I'd appreciate all your efforts at keeping the peace.
Relax, Tony. Shooting's over for now. At least my end of it.
Yeah, I hope you're right. And the thought that losing Lucas could pull Bobbie away from Stefan completely. I can't believe that she would risk losing custody of her son to stay with him. Maybe once she gets some distance, you know, maybe all this will turn out right again, because the last thing I want to do is hurt Bobbie any more than I already have. Chandler, if you not say anything about the custody suit to anyone, not even Laura.
No problem. And I'll see if I can come up with something you can use in court against Cassadine.
Okay. You can leave me a message at the office or at the brownstone. I practically live there now.
Okay. Good night, Ms. Roberts. Feel better.
Oh, I already do.
Bye.
You really feel better?
Yeah. Oh, this. That helps more than aspirin.
Well, you can have all you want of this and never take too much. Are you sure you're all right? You seemed almost frightened when you walked in.
Well, I was kind of surprised to see Luke here. You know, it's not a big secret. He hates my guts, and it scares me a little bit. He's not a nice man.
He would never hurt you, though.
And, you know, I totally blew off Katherine Bell after you took a risk and you recommended me. Are you mad?
Because you're sick? No, I was worried, actually. I'm still worried. Why don't you lie down and, do you want me to make you some tea?
Well, tea sounds great, but I'll make it.
No, no. Down. Sit. I'll make the tea. I'd give anything to get Bobbie back.
You know what? Forget the tea. I think I need my original prescription.
As in me?
You, yes. Lots and lots of you. As long as I have that, everything's okay. I love you, Tony.
I love you, Carly.
Where do you want them?
On the table, it's fine. Do you get everything?
Yeah, everything except the arugula. It wasn't fresh. What?
I didn't know you knew what arugula was, let alone whether or not it was fresh.
Well, then why get me to go shopping for you?
I figured you'd ask the produce guy.
No, I mean, Why not go yourself? It's not like when you were stuck up in that cab and the grocery store's only a mile away.
I have things to do here.
Vacuum?
So what if it was vacuum?